What's up, everybody? I'm Jesse Showalter, and in this episode, I'm going to show you how I use an application called Notion to organize everything in my life as a designer. If you haven't heard of it, Notion is an all-in-one note-taking platform that's about so much more than just taking notes. It's got calendars and databases and Kanban Trello-esque boards. It's your Basecamp and your Google Drive and your to-do list shoved all into one. It's like all of these programs that you've tried to figure out how to use had a really easy-to-use magical love baby. So there's three ways that I really use Notion as a designer. And the first way is to organize my life. As a designer, an entrepreneur, a content creator, there's so many different facets and aspects of what I do. I'm also a husband and a father, and I also do ministry at my church. So there's so much to be done. I have to organize all of that. Otherwise, each individual component or silo of my life starts to get disorganized. And so Notion allows me to bring all those things together and actually organize my life. So you can see I have Notion open on my desktop. Left-hand column is all of the different things that I've created, all the content kind of organized. It looks a little messy. I'll explain it later as we go. And then over on the right-hand side, you have where all that content shows up. If you've never used Notion, really it's all about creating workspaces. And then within those workspaces, you have pages, and you can create pages inside of pages. You can create tables and boards and links and note pages and schedules and calendars. I use all of that pretty much. So I'll just show you the way that I've organized everything is I have this one single workspace called home, and inside of it, I have all of those different silos or areas of my life. To-do list, I have church stuff, I have my reading list, my mentorships that I do, freelance projects, YouTube, income streams, personal brand stuff. I'm trying to design board games, that's an aspect of my life. I have a podcast called Biblical Lenses, that's an aspect of my life. And so all of it is kind of organized in its own individual thing. Just tapping on home here allows me to open up this workspace. I can see my to-do list. I have that laid out in kind of a Kanban Trello board style. And then I have all of these areas below, and they're broken up by simple headers. If I want to create a header, I use the short form of typing in hashtags. It's kind of like markdown, and hitting spacebar, and now I get a heading two. If I want a heading one, it's just a single one of those. Or you could type in slash and heading, and you get those as well. So I could put like family here, and then I could come in here and create a page just like that called family goals, okay? So now I've made a family goals board. I'm gonna add a little icon, maybe like, yeah, let's do that little icon right there. I could add a cover, whatever I want to do. But when I go back to home, look, there it is. My family goals page is there inside of this little kind of section that I've created. So we're just going to delete those for now. And that is how I organize my life. Each of my individual pieces of my life have their own page and section. They all funnel into this kind of homepage dashboard, this workspace of mine, and I can kind of keep things together. That is the first thing, organizing my life. The second way that I use Notion as a designer is to actually organize my projects. You can see my freelance projects down here, but I also have my YouTube information and ideas for different income streams, things that represent or pertain to my personal brand, so on and so forth. So if I click over on freelance projects, you can see I have active and I have archived stuff. Again, this is just a heading, and then these things are just moved around to wherever I want to put them and dropped into place. So I can come over here and I can look at any particular project, like this Android UI project that I was working on. Most of my projects look something like this. It's like its own personal dashboard for everything that takes place with the project. I have a description and a title of the project, pertinent links, requirements, kind of a layout of the scope of the project, as well as payment schedule and other information. I have a Kanban style to-do board, as well as embedding any links of the actual project. In this case, I actually just embedded the Figma file, and you can actually interact with it live because Figma's rad like that. This all-in-one approach to working with projects, organizing projects, has been so helpful. I used to use things like Basecamp or other project management software, and they all had their constraints that I couldn't really work around. Notion is just a blank page. It allows you to do whatever you want to do. I actually use this. I don't create custom proposals anymore. I just create this interactive dashboard and I send the link to the client and they interact with me. I literally just share them on it. I give it, you know, public access, a link, and I invite them to this document. That way they can see all the information, they can see the files, they have access to everything that I'm building. They can comment on things and share their ideas, and it becomes like a Google Docs / Basecamp / note-taking / project management / CRM. It's just all the things. And this approach has been absolutely mind-blowing. I'll pretty much never go back to one of those other solutions because this can be anything that I want it to be. If the client says they need a calendar for it, I can create a calendar. If the client says that they need a repository of images or mood boards, I can create all of that right here, and they don't have to go to a bunch of other places. That's really nice. The third and final way that I use Notion as a designer is to organize all of my tasks. I break everything down into goals and sub-goals, tasks and sub-tasks. And so I have tasks for my personal life and for projects and for all sorts of things. And I use task lists to do that. I used to use Trello, and then I tried using different to-do lists, and they just always felt too constrained, and I couldn't make them do everything that I wanted to do. And if I could make that to-do list capable of doing what I wanted to do, it didn't integrate into other things, and then I had to have project management over here and to-do lists over here, and there was just nothing. And for me, Notion is that all-in-one that allows me to do task management as well. And so I take huge advantage of the Kanban board approach, where I can create things in columns and I can move them over from this week to today or next week over into this week. It's just really fluid and really agile. It allows me to do with it whatever I want to do with it. And so if I don't accomplish tasks, that's okay. I can just move them over and reassess things. I have my main task list on my homepage, but then inside each one of my projects, you'll find also different tasks that need to be done. You can see I've completed all the tasks for this one. Same thing for like my YouTube content. You can see I check things off when they're filmed and then published. And so everything has a task list, and I'm actually building out a database. I'll tell you about it in another video on how I can have all of these different individual task lists and then filter them into one master task list that I can see at a glance. I'm getting really close to having that finished, so I'll share that with you when I get done. Well, that's it. That's how I use Notion to organize my life as a designer. I hope you guys liked the video. If you did, make sure to leave a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. I do tons of videos about design and development and life just like this one, so maybe stick around. If you're interested in trying out Notion for yourself, there's a link down in the description. See if it's for you. Also, if you have any questions, leave those down in the comments. I hope you guys are having an amazing week. I hope you're designing amazing things. I hope you're making amazing things. And I hope you're organizing all of the things. See you in the next one.